my husband makes movies to make them. He lives a kind of dream.
The second wave was to meet a playwright named Mario Frati, whom I met through Ed Kliban, who was an Italian playwright, and we had conversations. The idea being that he would obviously take what I had written and address it as a playwright. We had very little success with anybody being interested in it, except it was ultimately accepted by the Eugene O'Neill organization to do a staged reading up at the O'Neill, which we did for a couple of weeks. And when we did it, there was a young director who was working in New York, who had just come to New York from Baltimore, named Howard Ashman, who came to direct it. And he was absolutely wonderful and incredibly helpful. We did this reading. It was very successful. People apparently loved the music. One of the people who came to see it was Katharine Hepburn, who lived nearby. And I only learned later that she wrote a letter to Fellini after seeing it, saying, "I've just seen this marvelous musical version of Your 8 1/2 by a young man, and I think it's very wonderful." I didn't know that until Fellini told me, when I met Fellini, that he had received this letter from Katharine Hepburn. It took a while. Ultimately, after the O'Neill, we applied to the Richard Rogers Foundation, and we were the recipients of the first Richard Rogers Award. And there was to have been a small production downtown of this show. To direct it, Tommy Tune was approached. And when he heard a tape of the music, he called me and said, "Let's meet in New York," and I met him. And he said, I really must direct this, and I don't think that you should accept this award. I think you should give back the award and not do it for 2 weeks downtown, and instead, we should bring this to Broadway."